Digital signatures will be used for the achieving of the property called non-repudiation. The non-repudiation property can be achieved with the help of this digital signatures. So digital signatures are used worldwide to verify the authenticity of the message and confirm that they have not been altered in transmission. The digital signature algorithms is a digital signature standard for federal information processing standards and uses the public key cryptography for generating the digital signatures. So in the symmetric key cryptography, we don't have the facility of achieving non-repudiation because we use the same key there for the both encryption and decryption. Because in the public key, we have different keys for the encryption and decryption, especially called as public key and private key. For encryption, we use public private key of the send receiver, we use public key of the receiver, and the receiver will decrypt it via the private key. But in case of signature, the one who want to sign, they have to sign with the private key. And who want to verify, they will do with the public key. So quite reverse in the signature. So the elliptic curve digital signature algorithm is a version of the standard digital signature algorithm using elliptic curves. So in cryptography, you might have studied the digital signature algorithm, but it is an extension. This ECDSA, elliptic curve digital signature algorithm, is a simple version extension of the DSA. ECDSA has more advantage over RSA digital signature in terms of its small key size, and it is beneficial because it can be computed on the small devices also, where battery is operated, where the devices operate on battery. Okay, so are beneficial in environments where resources such as storage space are limited. In addition, it runs its key and signature generation algorithms so much faster than the RSA algorithm. So we have seen the ECC is far better than the RSA. That is the reason we have gone to this. And in the digital signature generation also, it is far better than the RSA digital signature. So ECDSA has two phases. First one is signature generation phase. Second one is signature verification phase. We will see the signature generation phase. ECDSA signature generation, in which we require the group, that is on which group you are going to operate. This is finite group that you are going to generate the keys. D value, N is the prime number, hash function. For example, you may take a SHA-256 here, and a message M, which message you want to encrypt. Compute a random integer k within the prime number. If the prime number is too large, obviously you will take a big random number k and perform k multiplication on the group, that is the public key or whatever the key value that you got in the group. With that you multiply it so that you will get a value. That is, if you perform the multiplication, you will get a value x1 comma y1. Now consider this x1 value and take it as an integer value, and compute the following one. So third step, r is equal to x1 mod n. So if you multiply this, if you perform modulo operation on x1 with the prime number, that is n, then if you get 0, then go to step 1 and choose a new random number, and again multiply with the point, and take the x1 value. Again, this x1 value modulo n need to be calculated. If it is not equal to 0, then go to the step 4. If it is equal to 0, then choose another random number. Like that you have to do it. So once this compute step 3 is successful, and you got a value x1, which is if you perform modulo with the n, it is not equal to 0, then whatever the random number you have taken, you compute the inverse of that particular random number. So k inverse mod n. Now keep that like that. Next, compute the hash of m. That is, we have to consider the SHA 256. This 256 SHA 256 perform cryptographic hashing with the message m, and convert this whatever the message raised you got, that you convert into an integer value e. So the message raised will be generated in the hexadecimal form, and this one will be converted into the bit string, that is into the integer form. Now this small e will be considered. Now the inverse modulo we have calculated, that inverse value s is equal to k inverse of this integer plus the key that what you are going to use, that is a private key here. D is the private key. D into r value that you have obtained here. You are supposed to perform the multiplication and perform modulo with the prime number that you have selected. Now you will get the small s. This is what is called signature. If s is equal to 0, that means s should not be 0. S should be greater than 0 only. If s is equal to 0, then go to step 1 and choose another random number to do this ask. So mostly you will not get s is equal to 0 and r is equal to 0 if you are having bad luck, then you may get it. Otherwise it's very difficult to get it, because if you choose a large prime number, then mostly you will not get this kind of problem. But if you are working with small numbers, as just now we have seen as Z7 of 1, 1, like that, there is a chance that you will get 0. Our most 60 to 70% chances will be there, because you will get 0 here. So that is the reason. If you work with a large prime number as a prime as a key, then you will not get this particular r is equal to 0 or something. So once you obtain this signature, the signature of the message m is equal to r comma s. This r value and the signature s. This is the signature, and this signature will be sent out along with the message. Now this r comma s, m, n, e, g, q and the cryptographic hash function will be the input. Now you are supposed to decide whether to accept this r comma s signature or not. The signature was done using the private key here. Now this verification will be done using the public key. Verify r and s are integers in the interval 1 comma n minus 1. That means this r and s values are belong to the prime number. Say for example you have considered a prime number, because whatever the r and s values will come, that will fall under the same prime number. If it is more than the prime number, then obviously there is a mistake in doing this, because we always do perform the modulo operation here, so automatically everything will fall under the same prime number. So if it is greater than that, then it is not a valid signature to verify. So here itself you can reject it. So interval of 1 comma n, n minus 1, then perform the computation of the message. So you have a message sent, so send down to the cryptographic hash function and convert this bit string to integer e. Just now as you have done in the signature generation. So once you do this, whatever the resultant value you will get, w is equal to s inverse, that is signature inverse, mod n. This s value you perform inverse modulo with n. Now compute u1 is equal to ew, okay, which is the e is the public key here, okay, ew mod n, and u2 is equal to rw, so r value that you already got in the signature, and w you have computed here, rw mod n. Now compute x is equal to u1 into g, okay, plus u2 into q. So g is the public key, g is the key that where you have agreed on, and u2 into q. If x is point at infinity, reject the signature. Otherwise convert the x1 of capital X to an integer, okay, and perform this v is equal to x1 mod n, just how you have done here, okay, in the signature generation you do it. So if v is equal to the r value that you have got, then accept the signature, otherwise reject the signature. So this is the step by step procedure that you are supposed to do, and this ECDSA is broadly classified into signature generation and verification, and it is for your understanding purpose. You may also try it with some messages and all, but you cannot do on with hand on paper. Obviously, you require some tools for this. But if you can understand and remember the way of ECDSA algorithm, then if you are working on the security projects or if you are performing research in the security projects, this certainly this ECDSA algorithm will help you. Anyhow, if you work in Python or if you work in Java, there are supporting libraries are there. You may work with those supporting libraries. But to work with those supporting libraries, first of all, you should have the basic understanding of how the ECDSA algorithm works. Otherwise, you cannot pass the parameters and you cannot get the signature. So this is the functionality of the ECDSA signature algorithm, and it's a very, very popular algorithm. Whenever you use the elliptic curve cryptography as the public key algorithm for your applications.